So today, inshallah, we take meeting number 9 or lecture number 9. This meeting talking about the graph. All of this meeting talking about the graph. Our agenda for this meeting, we make an introduction to the theory of the graph. And after then, we talking about the graph definition. What is the graph presentation? We take two type of search based on the graph, the breadth first and the depth first search. In the last of this chapter, we take Dijkstra algorithm and Kruskal algorithm. This is two algorithms based on the graph, Dijkstra algorithm and Kruskal algorithm. We start our introduction by taking the CV of this scientist, Leonhard Euler. Leonhard Euler. This a mathematician, Swiss mathematician. Euler, when he in the age of 20 years, he moved to Russia to study at the Academy of Science at St. Petersburg. He became professor of physics at the age of 23, professor of mathematics at the age of 26. He contributed or made progress for solving the theory of Fermat last theory. He is introduced the notation of pi. All of us know the pi constant. Euler, he is the person that introduced a notation of pi and sigma in the mathematics. At the age of 31, he lost the sight at his right eye and later become totally blind. He contributed in his life by making 886 books and paper and still publishing after 50 years after his death. Okay. So during this Euler life, he heard about the problem of seven bridge of Königsberg. This is all the history introduction. At Königsberg, there are a river. This river called Pregel. This river ran through the town and divide it into four land. Again, the seven bridge problem of Königsberg. Starting by there are a river, there is a river called Pregel, ran through this town of Königsberg, and divide the town, as you can see in this map, into four land area. In the middle, there is island in the middle, and the river was spanned by seven bridge. The people of the town tried to walk around. The people of this town tried to solve the puzzle of this seven bridge to find a bus around the center that cross all the seven bridge once and only once. Look at more detail in this problem. Look, this is our problem. You can see the seven bridge. This is the first bridge, second bridge, third bridge, fourth, fifth, sixth bridge. This is seven bridge. What is the problem? The problem, we need to make a route across the river to walking over the seven bridge once and only once. You are not allowed to cross the bridge more than once. Do you understand the problem? Do you understand the problem? Do you understand the problem here? This is the river, Brijel River, and we need to solve this puzzle. This puzzle called the Seven Bridge of Königsberg. When a person like this cross the Seven Bridge here, this person cross the Seven Bridge, then he cross the second bridge. He walk in the island and cross the third bridge and walk in this area and cross the fourth bridge and then go to from this direction and cross the fifth edge, sixth edge and exit. Okay, he doesn't walk over the seven bridge. This bridge is not crossed, so he doesn't solve the seven bridge. Do you understand this puzzle? Do you understand this puzzle? Do you understand the puzzle? Okay. So, from this problem, Euler invented the theory of the graph, network of the graph. From here, you can look, this is the seven bridge. We have 4 point here, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can make a graph consist of vertex or a node and the arc. An arc that connect between two vertex or two node. This is called a network of the graph. Like this person. This person move from here. This is bridge is the first vertex. This is bridge is the second vertex, third vertex, fourth vertex, fifth, and this the sixth vertex. Between the two vertex called arc or edge. A vertex called node or vertex. Between the two vertex we called it arc or edge. How to solve this problem? Walking of the people around the river to cross all the seven bridge, it considered as drawing a network on a paper without lifting up or lifting your pencil or going over a line. It should be walking once and only once. Once and only once to cross all the seven bridge to solve this problem. Okay, so Euler said that there are odd vertex and even vertex. An odd vertex that has odd number of edge or arc. You can see here an odd vertex and an even vertex. What is the difference between an odd and an even? An even has an even number of arc. You can see this node contain two arc, so it is even. This node contain 1, 2, 3 arc, so it is odd. Okay, this is 1, 2. This is a loop. It is considered as one. So all of this are one. So it is odd. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. It is even. This is odd. Why? It is one. And so on. Euler said that if the graph like this, then a number of odd degree vertex, a number of odd degree vertex may be 0 or 2. If you make a network of graph like this to solve the seven bridge of Königsberg, So you will find the number of odd vertex 0 or 2. This is a notice from Euler. So when a number of odd vertex 0, so the start here equal the end, no network. When a number of odd vertex are 2, so the start not equal the end of the graph. You will find in the previous, we start from one bridge and end with another bridge. Again, this is because there is two odd vertex, two odd vertex. Okay, so we need to know some terminology about the graph. What is the circuit and what is the bus? What is the circuit and what is the bus? A circuit means the graph contain every edge of the graph. A bus, a simple bus containing every edge of the graph. So, theory number one, a finite graph, it is a circuit that connected all vertex that have even degree. A finite bus, it is not circuit or simple circuit if and only if it is connected and exactly has two vertex have odd degree. A bus that has two odd vertex degree, that have two vertex that have odd degree, this is called finite graph. Finite graph that has Euler bus. A circuit connected all vertex, connected all vertex. For example, this is called circuit. Why circuit? We connect all the vertex like this from one, for example, from one to two, from two to three, from three to one. This is simple circuit, simple circuit. When your graph the start not equal to n, this is called bus from 1 to 2, for example, and from 2 to 3. So the start here not equal to n, this is called finite bus. Let's start with some terminology about what is the graph. As you can see here, a graph consists of vertex or node and the edge. Vertex and edge. The contents of the graph is ordered pair of vertex and edge. For example, a vertex in this graph, one in node number one, node number two, node number three. What is the edge? One from one to two, this is the first edge, from between three and two, and between one and three. A simple graph contains no loops. This is a simple graph. Why? There is no loop and no multiple edge. What is the loop like this? You can find the loop like this. A node return to itself. This is called self loop. A simple graph doesn't contain any loops. Directed multiple bus means like this. From one to two, there is more than one bus between one and two. There is parallel bus or multiple bus. So a simple graph doesn't contain loop or multiple bus or parallel bus like this graph. A directed graph, any edge directed from one node to another. So in this graph, there is a direction from one to two, and from one to three, and from three to node number two. This is called directed graph. You can see that every arrow has direction from 1 to 3, for example, from 3 to node number 2, from 1 to node number 2. Okay, do you understand this? Is it clear for this? Is it clear? Do you understand? Okay. Now, you can find between any R or edge, a two node, for example, U and V, the end point of this arc, of this edge. V and U, the end point of this edge. Also, V has A, D, B. V has three arc, three edge. A, B, and D. Okay? Number of edge called a degree of the node, a degree of the vertex. For example, how many edge for the node X? How many edge for the node X? You can see B, D, E, G, H, I. Yes? D with us or not? D with us or not? How many edge from X? Yes. Yes, Ruqayya. It is 5. For another example, a degree of the node number V. A degree of the V node. What's the degree of the V node? Yes, it is 3, A, B, and D. Yes. Another terminology, the parallel edge, you can see that the H and the I parallel edge. Why? This is between the same nodes. The end point of the H and the I are the same, X and Z. So, the H and I considered as parallel edge or parallel arc. A self loop like J, self loop. The edge from the node to itself again. This is called self node. Okay. Bus, we have two type of bus. Bus, any sequence of visited vertex and visited edge. Begin with a vertex, end with a vertex. Bus begin with a node and end with another node. So, a simple bus, for example, from V to X to Z. This is called a simple bus. Why? No vertex visited more than once. Look at another bus from U to W to X. From U to W to X, then to Y, again to W, then to V. This is called not simple bus. Why? We visit the W node twice. We visit the W node twice. You can see that V, X, Z, simple bus. Why? V and X and Z, unique bus. No, nodes are visited more than once. But in the next example, in the next example, U, W, X, Y, W again, and V. We visited W twice, as you can see here. W visited twist. It is not a simple bus. Do you understand the difference between simple and the not simple bus? Is it clear? Okay. Now, some properties of the graph. If you have n number of vertex, n number of vertex n, n number of edges m. So, the summation of all the degree of all node in the graph equal to m. Look for this graph. What is the degree of this node? What is the degree of this node? What is the degree of this node? Yes, 3. Also for this, 3. Also for this, 3. Also for this, 3. What is the summation of all degree? What is the summation of all degree? Summation of all degree equal what? Yes, 12. So, m, what is the number of m here? M, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You will find 2 by 6 equal 12. So, summation of degree equal 2m. 2 by 6 equal 12. Yes, it is right. Also, you will find this property. A number of each should less than or equal n by n minus 1 over 2. N equal 4. N minus 1 equal 3. 4 by 3, 12 over 2 give you 6. Yes, it is 6. So, m less than or equal 6. Yes. A degree, a max degree, a max degree n minus 1. A maximum degree n minus 1. We have 4 degree, so the maximum degree 3. 3 to connect all degree. To connect all node, you need n minus 1 degree. Okay? Do you understand this properties? Is it clear for this properties? What is your problem, Abdullah? What is your problem? Again? Okay, again. Again. Look. N, we refer to a number of vertex by this symbol, N. A number, N number of vertex. For example, here in this example, N equal 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 vertex. M, a number of each. For example, here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. M here equal 6 and N equal 4. Okay. He tell you the first property that is summation of all degree equal 2M. M here equal 6. So, a summation of all degree here equal 12. You can check this by yourself. How? A degree of this node 3. For this node 3. For this node 3. For this node 3. If you summation all the degree, you will find it true. 12. Is it clear for this? Is it clear for this property? Okay. The second property, Abdullah. L-M, a number of each, should be less than or equal n by n minus 1 over 2. N 4, N here in this example 4. N minus 1 means 3. 4 by 3, 12. 12 over 2 give you 6. Yes, our M in this example equals 6. If you have 4 degree, 4 vertex, if you have 4 nodes or 4 vertex, so the maximum degree n minus 1. If you have 4 vertex. So the maximum degree 3 n minus 1. Why? If I has, for example, 3 node, what is the maximum degree for any node? If you have 3 node, for example, what is the maximum degree for any node? 1 and 2. N minus 1. To connect from this node, to connect all node, you need N minus 1 each, 2. So this is property tell you that the maximum degree for any node, N minus 1. The number of vertex minus 1. Is it clear now? Is it clear now, Abdullah? And Ruqayya? Okay. How to represent the graph? In this example, we convert the graph to mathematical array, mathematical representation. You study it in MT131. You study the 131 course? Do you study the 131 course? Yes. You study this two matrix in the MT131 course, adjacency matrix and incidence matrix. In the adjacency matrix, the row is the vertex. Also, the column are the vertex. We start from zero, row number 0, 1, 2, 3. We have four node. Four node, U, V, W, Z, four node. And how many each? 1, 2, 3, 4 each. Okay. In the adjacency matrix, we make 4 by 4 matrix. Why 4 by 4? A number of vertex. In the adjacency matrix, a number of column equal a number of vertex. A number of row also equal a number of vertex. So the adjacency matrix equal 4 by 4 in this example. Okay. Between, look from U, I have U number 0, V number 1, W number 2, Z number 3. The same for the column. Here U, here V, here W, here Z. Between U and itself, no loop. Between U and the V, yes, there is one, but one. Here also, between V and the U, the same. So by this way, we construct the adjacency matrix. Instead of 0 and 1, you can put a label of the edge. For example, between U and the V, the E edge. Between the V and the U, the E edge, and so on. Instead of 0 and 1. Okay? Is it clear for adjacency matrix? We refresh our memory. You study it already in the 131 course. Yes? Is it right? You study it before. Is it right? Okay. Regarding the incidence matrix, in the incidence matrix, we represent a row by the vertex, a column by the edge. Again, the incidence matrix are very different. A row by the vertex index, a column by the edge. I have E, G, F, H. This is our column. A row, U, V, W, Z. Between U, E, H, connect U and V. G edge, connect U and W. F edge, connect V and W. H, connect W. Look, H connect any two end point for each W and Z. Both one in W and Z for the column H. Do you understand how to construct الانسيدنس ماتريكس. Is it clear for the incidence matrix? Okay. As you can see in the adjacent matrix again, you can put a label of the edge or 1 and 0. In old fashion, we put 1 and 0. 1 if there is an edge, 0 for no edge. In the new fashion, we put a label of the edge like this. E between U and V, or between V and U, the same. The adjacent matrix again, a number of row and the number of column equal in number of vertex. If you make a graph using Python, you need some method like a vertex count, a vertices, a edge count, a edges, get edge of U between U and V, a degree of the node, an incident edge to connect or make an incident of the edge V, insert vertex in the graph, insert edge in the graph, remove vertex or remove edge. All of this function are required to make a graph by using a Python implementation. We need all of this function. You can refer to LMS. You will find this file, lecture 9 code part. You will see all the code implementation of the graph using a Python implementation. No, Abdullah, just for self-study. Okay, Abdullah, you are not required to write the code of the graph or memorize this code. Okay? Now we move to the second topic after we understand what is the graph and the historical invention of the graph theory about the Euler scientist. So now we move to the how to search over the graph. How to search over the graph. We have two simple search. El Brits first search move to the graph in a Brits width. In a Brits width, for example, if you know to move this graph, we moving from S to A, from S to B, from S to C, then from A to D, from B to E, from C to F, then from D to G, then we visit all the node. This is like Brits. We move on the graph in a Brits where. Brits where. Again, from S to A, from S to B, from S to C. Then we visit all this level. After that, we continue to the next level by from A to D, from B to E, from C to F. Then from we visit all this level, then we visit from D to G. So this is, as you can see, in Brits fashion, in Brits word motion, as you can see. So it called Brits first search. What is the rules, the three rules to search using this type of Brits first? The first rule, the first step, visit the adjacent unvisited vertex, mark it visited, and insert it in a queue. The Brits first, we use the queue data structure. Again, in the Brits first, we use the queue data structure. The queue data structure. So after we visit the node, we put it in the queue. We insert it in the queue. And step number two, if no adjacent vertex is found, we remove the first vertex from the queue and repeat the two steps until the queue become empty. Complexity time of this type of search O of n plus m, n number of vertex, m a number of each. The complexity time of this type of bridge first, n plus m. You are not required to prove the time complexity for this type of search. Just to know the complexity time for this bridge first, n plus m. Let us take this example. We have this graph. The first pass from A to B, So we insert the B in the queue. Again, the first visit, if we begin from A, the A is not inserted. If we begin from A, to B, we insert the B in the queue. Then, from A to C, we insert the C. Then, from A to D, we insert D. So, this is the first level, the first level that we visited in the first level. We insert the B, C, and D. Then, after we bought D, we reach at this dead point. No other node in this level. So, what's the next step? The next step, remove the first node in the queue, B. And go to the next, from B, you can go to E. We remove the B and start from B to E and insert E. E is a deadline, dead end of the tree. So we remove C and go to begin again from the C and from C to F, we insert the F. So after we insert the F, we insert all the second level of this graph. So by this level, we visit all the nodes inside this example. Again, do you understand it or again? Again, Fatima and Abdullah. Look again. We start from the node A. The starting node not inserted in the queue. Okay. The breadth first from A to B, from A to C, from A to D, as we make in this example. From in Brett's word motion, from S to A, from S to B, from S to C. So in the same in this example, from A to B, from A to C, from A to D. So after each, after you visit B, bottle B in the queue. From A to B, we bottle B in the queue. From A to C, we bottle C in the queue. From A to D, we bottle D in the queue. After we both D, no other node in this level. So D, dead end node. So remove the first one in the queue. Who is the first node? Which is the first node now? Which is the first node after we both D in the queue? Which is the first node? Yes, Ruqayya. After we bottle B and C and D, and visit all node in this level, the first node to be removed B. We remove the B and starting again from the B. Okay. The B to C, no. The C is inserted already. The B to A, no. The B to E. So we go to from B to E and insert till E. Okay. The E is a dead end in this graph. So after we insert till E, we remove C. We remove C, the first node in this queue. Go to the removed node and begin again. From C to E, inserted the E already. From C to D, D inserted. From C to F, F not inserted. So we go to from C to F. From C to F and insert the F. So after we insert the F, we insert, we visit all the node inside this graph. Okay? Do you understand now? Is it clear now? Okay. So after we visit A first, B, C, D, E, F. El breadth first order in this, in the previous example, from A to B, from A to C, from A to D. So the order is A, B, C, D. Then from B to E and from C to F. So the order is A, B, C, D, E, F. As you can see, A, B, C, D, Brits, E, F, Brits. From its name, it's a Brits. We visit by using the Brits probability. The Brits probability, as you can see in this example. Okay? Do you understand? Is it clear? The second search of the graph, it dips first. In the depths, it is the reversed order of the breadth first. We starting from S to A in a depth, not in breadth. So we continue from A to D, from D to G. We reach at dead end. So from G again to the up, from G to E, from E to B. Okay, then it'll be not move back again to S. We begin already from S. So stop at B and again from G to F and from F to C to visit all node. So in this type of search, you go to in depth. You go to in depth, up or down, in depth. So we use the stack data structure. In the breadth, we use the queue. If you remember, in the breadth first search, we use the queue. In the depths, we use the stack. In the depths, we use the stack to insert the visited node. What is the steps? Three steps to search using depths first. We visit the adjacent unvisited vertex, mark at visited and push it in the stack. If no adjacent vertex, pop up the vertex from the stack and repeat rule 1 and rule 2 until your stack become empty. Also, like the breadth first, depth first take complexity time n plus m. The n, the number of vertex, the m, the number of each. So let us take example. Look at this example. In the depths, we begin from A, and in this depths, we bottle A. we bottle A in the stack. From A to B, we bottle A and the B in the stack. Then, from B to C, we bottle C in the stack. From A to B, A, B in the stack. From B to C, C in the stack. As you know, from the chapter of the data structure, the stack last in, first out. Last in, first out. C is the last in. Last in, C. So it is the top of the stack. It is the top of the stack. So after we reach C, we go to from C to D. From C to D. Then D is end point, end node. We go again from C to E. So our stack, it become, sorry, after we reach D end point, so we remove D from the stack and go to again from C to E. Again, this step. We bought again from A to B, we bought the A and the B. From B to C, we bought the C. From C to D, we bought a D. After we reach D, we can't move again to A. So we stop here and remove D from the stack and begin again from the C to E and the bottle E. So after we bottle E, we visit all the node using depth first. So you can see that A, B, C, D, E, in order of the depth first search in this example. Do you understand this example or again? Do you understand this example or again? Okay, that's great. Now, okay, now we move to the our two algorithms for the graph today, Dijkstra algorithm, then we take Kruskal or spanning tree, the minimum spanning tree algorithm. Dijkstra algorithm working in the weighted directed graph. Weighted directed graph. Again, a Dijkstra algorithm work on a weighted directed graph. Between the edge has a weight. The edge has a weight, positive weight. This type of algorithm solve a traveler salesperson problem. When the traveler has many city to visit and he want to get the optimal bus to visit all city, so or get the shortest bus between the cities, so we need this type of algorithm, Dijkstra algorithm. Each city represent a node or a vertex, and the edge represent a distance between the two pair of city. Again, this algorithm of the Dijkstra algorithm represent or solve a type of problem like a traveler sales person algorithm. In this type of problem, the vertex are the cities that the traveler visit, and the distance or distance between two cities present in each. Okay, what is the problem statement? I have a graph G and a vertex V in nodes and in each. A vertex and a number of cities. Each distance or weighted directed lines between every two vertex and the graph that represent the V and E. In this type of graph, to understand it, let us take example and go to back again to this solution steps to understand it. Look at this graph. What do you see? We see some nodes A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Between every two node, you can see directed graph. And this directed edge, and this edge has a weight, positive weight. Positive weight. Okay? Can you see this graph well? Can you see this graph well? Can you see this graph? There are some nodes and directed edge, and every edge has a weight. What is the first step in this algorithm? In this algorithm, we make a table like this to solve this graph using Dijkstra algorithm. We make a table like this. Table like this. If we starting from the A node, the initial column, you start from A, but zero like this, and all the other node has infinity weight. Again, the first step in the Dijkstra algorithm, from the starting node, but zero. Zero means the starting node. Zero means the starting node. All other nodes are marked by infinity. Are marked by infinity. Back again. Look, he tell me that. He tell me that make the first U, the starting node U, zero. And the other node, infinity. The starting node, zero. The other node, infinity. Okay. This is the first step. Okay. Look with me. Look with me. From A. How many directed graph starting from A to the other node? How many edge from A directed from A to the other nodes? Tell me by the bus from A directed to B. This is one. From A directed to D. This is the second. This is not. This is from C to A, not from A. So this is not counted. This is from C to A, not counted. Okay, so in the next step, we put in the B two. Look, next step, we go from A to B, and instead of infinity, we put two over B. Zero plus two equal two. Zero plus one equal one. And the other is still infinity. Look at the table. In the first column, we put two at the node B, we put one at the node D. Do you understand the second step? Do you understand the second step? Is it clear? Do you understand the second step in this Dijkstra algorithm? Is it clear for all students? Okay. Now, what is the minimum? One or two? What is the minimum? One or two? We choose the minimum between one and two. What is the minimum? Yes, a D. We starting from D, a minimum bus. In the next step, we mark it. As you can see, we mark one by a yellow color. Why one? L1 and the two, we choose the minimum. The minimum is one. So we start from D. Okay. What is the directed bus? Again, repeat the process again. From D, what is the directed bus? We have this bus. We have this bus. We have this bus. We have this bus. Four bus. From D to E. So L weight become 1 plus 2 from A to E, 3. Look, from A to E, 3. What's this 3? 1 plus 2. Also, from A to C, 1 plus 2, 3. From A to G, 1 plus 4, 5. From A to F, 1 plus 8, 9. From A to B, still 2. Do you understand this step? Do you understand this step or not? Is it clear for this step? Why Osman? Again? Again Osman? Okay, again, again. Again, from the first, the first of this problem, Osman, we start from A. So we make this table. This table represent the iteration number, the initial 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. And the node A, B, we have in this, we have here in this example, 7 node A, B, C, D, E, F, G. In this example, we try to get the minimum distance. So, the first step, Osman, in the starting node A, we put 0, and the other we label with infinity, like this column, Osman. 0 and the other are infinity. Okay, Osman? Do you understand this example? Do you understand this step? Do you understand this step? Okay. A second step, Osman. From A, you have two directions. From A to B with the weight of 2. From A to D with a one direction. Okay. So, in the next step, Osman, from A to B, 2. 0 plus 2, make it, put it 2 over the B. 0 plus 1, put 1 within or beside a D. And in the second column, column number 1 here, in the B, put 2, label 2, and in the D, put label 1. Okay, Osman, do you understand the second step? Do you understand the second step? Is it clear for the second step, Osman? Okay. What is the minimum, Osman? A distance between A to B or A to D? What is the minimum, Osman? A B or a D? A 2 or a 1? What is the minimum? Yes, Osman. So, in the next step, we choose a D to begin. Look, Osman. We mark L1 to begin again. So we repeat the process again, Osman. From D, you have to four direction. From D to C, from D to E, from D to G, from D to F. Four direction. Okay. Look, how to label this direction, Osman? Look. From A to C, look, Osman, 1 plus 2, go to the C and put 3, go to the C and put 3. Look, Osman, again, from D to C, 2 plus this one, give you 3 here. From D to E, 2 plus this one, give you 3. From D to F, 8. 1 plus 8, 9. From D to G, 4. 4 plus 1, 5. D, from A to B, still 2. This is still the same. Still the same. Okay? Do you understand this step, Osman? Is it clear? Is it clear for this step? Okay. So, what is the minimum now? What is the minimum now? What is the minimum now in this column? What is the minimum now in this column? Yes, P. El B with label 2. Look, yes, it is B. Go to again to B. Go to again to B. Look. In this step, in this step, from B, we have B to D. D already visited. From B to D, 2 + 3 = 5. So D has 1 minimum. Don't put this. From B to E, 10. 10 plus 2, 12. So go to the E, you will find the 3. It is the minimum. Don't put 12. So we didn't make anything by from B. We didn't make any change from B. Why? Because E and D in the table is minimum than from A using through this node B. From look 10 plus 2 from A to E use through B give you 12. But the E here 3. Is 3 or 12 is the minimum? 3. So don't make any change. From A, B, D, you will find the 2 and the 3, 5. But from A to D is 1. 1 is the minimum. So don't put 5 inside the table. So the table is still the same. The table at the 3, still 3. At D, still 1. 1D visited already. We didn't throw it again. So we bought 3 again at C. We bought 3 again at E. So we bought 9 the same as F and 5 again at G. Okay, at this step, we choose E as the minimum. E as the minimum. Look, we begin from E now. E is 3. 1 plus 2 give you 3. Okay. From E, we have only one direction. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 6 give you 9. To G. G has 5. So, no change. Still C3. Still, if you notice that, we repeat again in not visited node. LA stopped because we begin it from the start. LB stopped. LD stopped. LE stopped because we visit it already. Now we repeat again in nodes that not visited yet. 3 and the 9 and the 5 still the same. Who is the minimum? C. 3. So from C to F, look, from C to F, 4 plus 5, 9, still the same. Sorry, from A to D, 1, from D to C, 2, 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 5, 1 plus 2 plus 5, give you 8, less than 9. So we bought it. Okay, and LG still the same. 4 plus 5 plus 1, it is not booted. 4 plus 5 plus 1, it is, sorry, no bus to the G from C. So LG still the same. So the remaining from us, 8. And sorry, 1 minute, please. Sorry for this interruption. Do you hear me? Is the voice clear again? Okay. Now we have 8 and 5. 8 and 5. So the minimum is 5. G. So we go to node G and start. To the G, 1 plus 4, it is 5. To go to F from G, 1 plus 4, 5, 5 plus 1, give you 6. 6 is less than 8. So we put a 6 in this table. So by visit, F is the last one and no other node. So we stop here. We visit all node. Look at the yellow marker cell. We visit the A, then D in the second iteration, then B in the third iteration, then E in the fourth iteration. In the fifth iteration, we visit C, then we visit G, then we end at the F, the last node. And you can see that we choose between 8 and 6. Eight and the 5 plus 1, 6 is the minimum. So we put a 6 at the table. Do you understand this example or again? Do you understand this example or again? Do you understand this example or again? Okay, so as you can see, we bought the end result, A with 0, B with 2, D with 1 from this table. The yellow marker is the yellow label that bought it over the cell, that bought it over the node. So as you can see, this is the weighted after we apply a Dijkstra algorithm. So you will find a shortest path from A to G is 5. 0 plus 1, 0 plus 1 plus, sorry, from A to G, 5. From A to E, 3. From A to F, 6. From A to B, 2, and so on. This is from the start to any node, you can put the weight by using Dijkstra algorithm, as you can see in this table. So the path from A to G through D, from A to D, 1. From D to G, 4. So 1 plus 4 give you 5, this way. A Dijkstra algorithm is considered as greedy algorithm. Why greedy algorithm? Because we choose level by level, and we can correct the previous level based on the new weight. As you can see, why greedy algorithm? Look, the weight from A to F, 9. In this level, but in level number 5, it become 8. In level number 6, it correct to be 6. Look at another example. Yes, this is the only example, F, that correct 3 times. The first measure at the first level, sorry, at the second level, F from A to F, 9, still 9, and in the level number 5, it updated or corrected to 8. And in the sixth level, it corrected to be 6. We choose the minimum. So this is the meaning of greedy algorithm. The greedy algorithm need to be correct after every level we can make update or correct to the our solution. So we need to search about the optimal path, not a local optimal path, not a global optimal path. At every step, we get the local solution, not the global solution. As you can see during the solution of the previous example. So for every visited node, we register the distance or shortest the distance to this vertex from the source. So after every level, the distance, we choose a minimum distance to record it in the table using this Dijkstra algorithm. So this algorithm again is of type greedy algorithm. Greedy algorithm. How many algorithms we study till now? We study a linear or a brute force that visit all node like a linear search. We study a divide and conquer algorithm, a divide and conquer algorithm like a merge sort, if you remember, a quick sort, quick select, a binary search. All of this algorithm are divide and conquer. This is the third type of algorithm we study, greedy algorithm. Greedy algorithm. A greedy algorithm need to be updated at every level. It give you local optimal solution, not the global optimal solution. Do you understand this? Is it clear for this Dijkstra algorithm? Is it clear? Okay. The last algorithm in this meeting, the minimum spanning tree. The minimum spanning tree. We represent our graph like a tree. Like tree. A tree is connected to each other, directed graph, acyclic graph. Acyclic graph means no loop. Acyclic graph means no loop. The spanning tree is a subgraph of all the tree that meets the condition to be acyclic and connected, a tree again, and connect every vertex of the original graph. The minimum spanning tree is a spanning tree with the minimum weight. The minimum spanning tree, the graph or the tree that has a minimum weight. The minimum weight of all subtree inside your graph. Let us take some example. An example of a minimum spanning tree or a spanning tree algorithm is Kruskal algorithm. Kruskal algorithm. This is algorithm make two steps. Sort the edge by its weight and increasing order, ascending order, and select an edge that doesn't generate a cycle. Look us, take example. Look at this example. Look at this example. In this example, we have some node A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. So we have in this example, 8 node with this each, as you can see, this is weighted. Okay. The first step to solve using the spanning tree algorithm or Kruskal algorithm to remove the loops and the barrel edge. So you have barrel edge here between E and G. Remove this. Remove what? Remove the maximum weight. Remove the maximum weight between 3 and 7. What is the maximum to remove? What is the maximum to remove between E and G? We choose to remove the maximum weight between the parallel edge. So we remove the edge with the 7. Also, we remove a loop. السيلف لوب ات ايتش وي ريموف ات. This is the first step. The second step, we arrange all the edge based on the weight. Who is the minimum weight here? Who is the minimum weight between D and E? This is the first. Then G and D, two. Yes. Then C and F, three. G and H, three. Then H and B, four. F and B, four. C and B, four. B and E, four. We forget this. Okay. So after four, five. Who is five? H and A. Then six. Between D and F, six. Then eight. Between A and B. Then between F and A, ten. So you will find our arrangement after we remove the loop and the multi edge or the parallel edge, we arrange this table between the D and the E, the last one, the D and the G, this one, the D and the G, two, the E and the G, three, the C and the D, three, this three. C and the G and the H, three. C and the F, also three. Then between the B and the C, four. B and C, this four. B and the E, also four. B and the F, four. B and the H, four. You will see all of this four. Then the five, A and the H, five. This is the only one. D and the left, six. D and the left, six. Then A and the B, eight. The last one, A and the left, ten. So we sort the edge based on its weight in ascending order, as you can see. This is step number two after we remove the loops and the parallel edge. Do you understand this? Two step. Do you understand this is two steps? Is it clear for the two steps? Is it clear for all students? Okay. Now we visit level by level. We begin from the last weight, D and E. Visited and visited. Okay. Then D and LG. So we visit LG also. E and LG. Okay. E and LG not visited. Why? E and LG, I bought X. Why? Can you know? Because I visited E and G before, I don't visit or take E and G bus. Why? Because I go to from D to E and D to G. So E and G are visited already. So no need to take this bus. This bus X, we visit it again. We visit it already. LG here. E here, we visit it already. Do you understand this? Why we bought X at EG? Do you understand? Yes, yes, Abdullah. Excellent, Abdullah. A cyclic, no loop. Don't make loop. Yes, excellent, Abdullah. Don't make loop when you visit a tree using the classical algorithm or the spanning tree algorithm. Okay, then C and D, visit C, yes, visit C. C not found. G and the H, yes, we visit the H. C and the F, look here. C and the F, yes, we visit it. B and C, yes, we visit the B. B and the E, what about your opinion? till now B and E are visited or not? B and E visited or not? Yes, not visit. B and F visit or not? No. B and H, no. A and H, yes. A and H, yes. So, after we mark A and H, you will see that all nodes are visited. Can you see that? At this steps, all nodes were visited. Yes, all nodes were visited. So, D and F, X. A and B, X. A and F, X. Y, we visit all nodes already. All of these buses already visited. So, this is not considered. Not considered. So, if you add the total cost, 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 3, 6. 9, 12, 16, 16 plus 5 give you 21. This is the total cost, a total distance for this spanning tree algorithm, or we called it Kruskal algorithm. Do you understand how this algorithm works? Okay, so a time complexity for the Dijkstra algorithm, it take O V square. L V is the number of vertex. A Dijkstra algorithm take time complexity V square. If you implement this algorithm using the adjacency matrix. If you implement the Dijkstra algorithm using a binary heap algorithm, this time complexity become E log V. E, edge. V, vertex. If we implement the Dijkstra algorithm using a binary heap, E log V. Using the adjacency matrix, V squared. The complexity of the Kruskal algorithm, it take E log E or E log V. Again, the time complexity of Kruskal algorithm, E log E or E log V. Okay? This is the time complexity for Kruskal algorithm and Dijkstra algorithm. Okay? Do you understand our meeting today? Is it clear for our meeting today? Is it clear for all students for our meeting today? Do you have any question in this meeting? Do you have any question in this meeting? All clear for this meeting? All clear for this meeting?